And on the sleeve of Spandau Ballet, one young man who'd failed as leader of a punk band raided the dressing up box and grabbed a golden chance to reinvent himself.
Adam Mann didn't have a band a year previously. There is a man of a deadline which, if he doesn't make it, then it's kind of all over for him. You may not lie.
I'd been waiting 4 years for the opportunity to go on television because Adam and the Ants had been around since 77, and then someone dropped out at Top of the Pops, and then we got a slot and we did Dog Eat Dog. One performance on Top of the Pops, I remember standing looking at the Stray Cats over there and Madness over there. It was like tribal, and they were ready to go, and you kind of knew what they could do. And it made me up my game.
As gung-ho as Adam's performance was, the studio audience for his debut kept their distance from his unfamiliar Burundi beat.
I remember Dog Eat Dog in particular. They didn't come anywhere near us, the crowd. They were like, really stayed right away from it.
Never mind the studio audience, the nation at home made up its mind after his debut. And soon Adam had a huge fan base, an army of young girls who bought into pop's biggest teen sensation since the Bay City Rollers.
Good morning.
Oh, good morning.
You sent the place into total turmoil. We've got hundreds and hundreds of young ladies all ringing up and melting our phones.
Oh, dear.
I want to speak to him!
When he returned to Top of the Pops in December with Ant Music, the failed punk was a star, and the refangled Top of the Pops was his new home.
Music, there was a lot more. The audience here, you had them right on the edge. That was the Thursday night. On the Saturday morning, we sold 250,000 records, and I couldn't walk down the street anymore. It was really the beginning of a whole different era in my life.
But in the same week that Ant Music debuted on Top of the Pops, tragedy struck.